Transformations have been a part of Dragon Ball since the manga began in the 1980s and have been very popular since their inception. Throughout this franchise, we have seen a variety of transformations from our heroes and villains alike. But as the decades and story arcs have drawn on, the new, higher forms have begun to lose their meaning, and the concept as a whole has unraveled to where it's questionable if they should still continue to exist. So in this video, we're going to be taking a look at 5 reasons why Dragon Ball should abandon transformations. Don't forget to like this video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel to stay up to date on all upcoming videos in the future. Now let's start first with number 5. They're running out of ideas. When transformations were originally introduced in Dragon Ball, it wasn't just a power-up for Goku, but a scary aspect of his character, as he could at any time transform into a giant ape and wreak uncontrollable havoc upon the world. Aside from escaping from Pilaf's castle, this form was never really necessary to move the plot forward and never used for any real victories. Goku's next form was one of legend, established by Vegeta and others to be incredibly powerful and ferocious, and Goku finally achieved this form while face to face with an unbeatable foe in Frieza, unlocking it out of pure rage and desperation. But after this, the forms basically began to be recycled without that much change. They got more muscular with grades 2 and 3, lost strain from grade 4, even the next step in the evolution of the form was pretty much just Super Saiyan with spikier hair and electricity. In Super Saiyan 3 was Super Saiyan 2 on steroids with long hair and no eyebrows. Come Dragon Ball Super, when the idea of God Ki and Super Saiyan God were introduced, it seemed like they might get a fresher take, but instead we got a slimmed down red-haired form which makes a single appearance, and then Super Saiyan Blue, which aside from the aura is just Super Saiyan with a blue color swap. None of these further transformations are actually original and are really just lazy. They throw in some new concepts like God Ki or Ki Control, but all they really do is make Goku stronger, which leads into number 4. They're becoming increasingly marginal. One of the biggest problems with transformations after Ozaru and Super Saiyan is that the forms really don't yield as much of an increase as before. Super Saiyan 2 is 2 times stronger than Super Saiyan, Super Saiyan 3 is 4 times Super Saiyan 2, and nobody even knows what the multipliers for God and Blue are. But the bigger problem isn't the multipliers, but the writing surrounding them. Gohan's Super Saiyan 2 could have beaten Cell, but after Cell comes back with his Zenkai, the power boost is irrelevant. Goku pulls Super Saiyan 3 out of nowhere and says he can defeat Buu with it, but Buu becomes far more powerful and Super Saiyan 3 is no longer any real threat to him. Goku achieves Super Saiyan God, but Beerus toys with him the entire fight and doesn't even use close to full power to defeat Goku. And finally, Goku achieves Super Saiyan Blue, which is weaker than Frieza and doesn't really decide the outcome of the arc. And many characters have come to match or surpass Goku's Super Saiyan Blue since he received it, making the form's increases irrelevant. If Goku or another fighter gets a new transformation, it should put them on another level and allow them to overcome their obstacles, but with Goku still not even close to Beerus at this point and characters being written to match his power, the gains of the transformations are always kept artificially small for the sake of the plot. And if the forms exist in spite of the plot and don't really move it forward in any real degree, then they shouldn't even exist at all, which leads into number 3. They exist for the wrong reasons. The higher transformations in Dragon Ball often don't exist to serve the plot or really to make any changes, but rather exist for financial and marketing reasons. Creating new forms is one of the easiest ways for Toei to sell more toys and merchandise, however, it's also one of the laziest. Toei and Toriyama could easily create more interesting and compelling characters with their own interesting abilities, but it's much easier to give Goku red hair, blue hair, green hair, white hair, and so on. That way they can not only sell one figure, but many, as they sell Super Saiyan God or Blue in Goku's Whis-Gi and his Classic Gi, and then in a Future Gi. And then since Toriyama has overemphasized Saiyans for years, and all of them can theoretically achieve this form, they can make toys and merchandise for all of them as well. Vegeta, Vegito, Gohan, and whoever else they decide on a whim to give the form. And they can also throw these forms on characters in the video games, so people will eat those up as well, especially if they're paid DLC. And most fans who crave these forms will eat it up, giving them their money and not seeing that they're being exploited, which also ties into another problem, fan service. A lot of what we've seen in Dragon Ball Super has been blatant fan service, characters getting stronger off screen with no good explanation, bringing others back from the dead, bringing back future Trunks, and of course, having a villain take over Goku's body naturally with his own different color transformation, which also was poorly executed and explained despite what other YouTubers may claim. It's all blatant fan pandering, so you'll keep watching, overhype this show on the internet, and go buy their merchandise and Blu-rays for several times the price they're actually worth. None of this is for the purposes of the story or to make a real compelling narrative, but just to make a buck, largely off of nostalgia, which leads into my next point. Number 2, it's the wrong direction to go in. Let's face the facts, Dragon Ball has changed a lot since it was first introduced. It was originally a Journey to the West spoof with a super strong child who knew martial arts and could turn into a giant ape. But by the time it reached Dragon Ball Z, it shifted to being more about power and attaining it. Super Saiyan was a form that made Goku 50 times stronger than his base without the drawbacks of the Kaioken technique, and it basically went from there with increasing numbers and multipliers. But in Dragon Ball Super, these numbers are irrelevant. The Saiyan's base forms are as strong as the plot requires them to be, and so is Super Saiyan Blue, as we get no real figures anymore. No one ever really knows when Goku is going full power anymore either, and seems to whip power out of nowhere like he did while facing Merged Zamasu, when it seemed like he wasn't even a match for Goku Black. So if the forms themselves have no real set increase or explanation, why should they continue to exist? Also, unlike Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball Z, Super hasn't really differentiated itself enough from its previous series. And this is largely because it continues to use the same plot points from Dragon Ball Z, while executing them more poorly and with a sliding scale of power that even those writing it don't care about or understand. Dragon Ball Z ended over 2 decades ago, and storytelling has evolved since then, even in anime. We've seen so many great dynamic series since, with characters who have different abilities and implement various strategies. However, when we watch Dragon Ball Super, it's the same old thing. Goku or someone gets angry, they unlock a new form with a new color, they get stronger, insert trope here. The series hasn't really evolved anywhere near as much as it should have and should be if it's going to continue to run. Super has talked time and time again about ki control, but our characters still seem more interested in getting more powerful and finding greater forms than learning to master their ki, and they shouldn't require a color swap to do that. Dragon Ball should take more inspiration from shows like Hunter x Hunter, having their characters learn new, powerful techniques. Goku should learn to control his ki to such a degree that he never needs to transform, as should the other Saiyans. Dragon Ball Super needs to stand apart from Dragon Ball Z, not be a rinse and repeat of it, which leads to my final point. Number 1, they're totally unnecessary. As I've already touched upon, this series really comes down to the writing, specifically Toei, Shueisha, Toyotaro, and of course, Akira Toriyama. And this is why many of the forms after Super Saiyan have fallen flat, because of how they're used within the story and how they're written to be used. Toriyama was the one who created Super Saiyan 3, but he's also the one who wrote Goku to not defeat Buu, the form to drain too much energy and never really affect the outcome. He's the one who made Super Saiyan Blue, but also the one who decided it wouldn't truly be discovered discovered on screen or affect the outcome of any major fight. So Toriyama can come up with any number of transformations he wants, but if he and the others don't write the form to accomplish anything, it ultimately falls flat and is shown to be pointless, either existing to sell merchandise, pad out the runtime, or to be a twist that exists for momentary excitement but ultimately falls short, like Trunks' Super Saiyan Rage or the concept of fusion. But this also means that transformations are totally pointless because Toriyama can write Goku, Vegeta, Gohan, and the rest to not need them. He can write them to have full mastery of ki without ever changing color. He can write new techniques, abilities, strategies, and dynamics to replace these at any moment. So there's no reason why the forms need to continue. Now, many will say it's to show Goku's progress, but that point makes no sense. In most other series, the main characters never transform, but we know they've improved because they show us or the writer explains it through dialogue. We didn't need to see Goku's hair change colors to see he was stronger before Goku became a Super Saiyan. We knew he was improving throughout Dragon Ball and Z without him ever transforming. Super has even done this by showing Goku and Vegeta in their base forms are more powerful than Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks. So this idea is total nonsense and being said by people who either don't pay attention to the show, don't remember it, or never actually watched it to begin with. In the end, the Dragon Ball franchise doesn't need transformations, either in-universe or from a writing standpoint. And if it is to really move forward and evolve, it needs to move away from them. If you like transformations, that's fine. They look cool and the concept is interesting. But you can easily rewatch Dragon Ball Z or play video games filled with them to get your fill. But if Dragon Ball is to really evolve and become even better as a franchise, it really needs to stop using transformations as a crutch and leave them behind. Because there's so many more cool concepts and possibilities just waiting to be discovered.
Yeah, and you better subscribe, enable those damn notifications.